Hello friends, welcome you all to this third video on Merck Sol. I am Dr. Pallavi Chaturvedi from Mumbai, Kandivli. And the first information that I am going to give you all today and the first appeal that I am going to make through this video is that do attend our month-end series webinars. In fact, all the webinars of HHF are really worthwhile. And once you all attend, you will see how your clinic prospers and how your patients multiply and your results multiply. So this is the confidence and the knowledge and the path that our HHF webinars really show to all the homeopaths across the globe. And with this appeal, I am going to proceed with the further narration on Merck Sol. And today I am going to share some cases on Merck Sol which I have seen in my clinic and in HHF seminars as well. So the first case, the first encounter on Merck Sol for me was a small child. Okay, this child, I narrated in the first video also, that he had loose motions for 2.5 to 3 months and I was changing medicines, nothing was working. And then, you know, one day I just sat down that this mother is coming every week to me and telling the same complaint for the child. Let me just think over. Because the mother had faith in homeopathy and I was giving results for her husband, her elder son. So she was persistent and she had that belief that yes, here I will be fine, although it is taking some time. So but then, you know, we as homeopath always have that guilt that if you are not able to treat a patient for a long time, no medicine is acting, what is the problem? So one day I just put my foot down, I said, nee, today I will just work on the case more seriously. So when I became more serious with the case, I realized that this boy is so mischievous, and I used to use that Logitech webcam at that time. So he would see that, you know, I'm recording her, his face is seen on the screen, and he would go and make all those kind of funny faces. And then the kind of mischief that, you know, he will always pull his elder brother's pant and he would pinch his mother and do anything weird. And he would always try to create a fuss wherever he goes, that, you know, kuch to karna hai, and some mischief he has to do. Without doing mischief, Merck Sol cannot sit still, okay? Lachesis will find amusement in something and engross oneself. But when we talk about Merck Sol does not want amusement. Merck Sol wants mischief everywhere. He will know that where I will tease and where the other person gets irritated, what is the point where if I do something, then they will shout and they will, you know, get agitated. And that is what he enjoys the most. So this boy, although having 8 to 10 loose motions daily, he is not complaining to his mother and he is just continuing with mischief all day. Mother is frustrated that, you know, that these two brothers, they always keep fighting. And the elder son was a very sincere fellow, and he would always say, whenever I sit to study, he has to come in between, he has to tear my page, he has to break my pencil, he has to put ink on my page, and he would always keep all these, doing all this, never allow me to do what I want to do. So that was a complaint of the brother, and then I put all these things together and then I prescribed him Merck Sol. Then another case was, another encounter of Merck Sol was with a uncle, elderly uncle. He was in his retired age group, and I would know about him from his wife as well, because wife was my first patient from that family. So she was a very sweet lady, typically carcinosin lady. And she always told me that, you know, whenever there is any conflict in the house, and I am the peacemaker of the house. So my husband is a little short tempered, but it's okay, I enjoy with him. And so I knew a little background that he is a short tempered fellow, and he had problem of lichen planus. The way he described about his lichen planus problem was that I have seen, and he had this problem for many years, like 15, 17 years something. And he's like, I have seen big doctors, and he named them, and he's like, I have taken the best of treatment, and somewhere it subsides and then it flares up, and you know, this doctor, he's from that side of the city, and this doctor has got big names. So that boasting kind of thing is there. They feel that they have done the best, and you cannot question them, or you cannot contradict them or say that, you know, you went wrong over here, or, you know, I have taken the best dietary measures and my lifestyle is so superb. And I knew his lifestyle was superb because we knew each other socially. So, you know, today also, he is in his 70s now, but morning and evening, daily, he is a person who goes to entire Thakur village cycling. You would always see him cycling, and he would have those polythens on his handles. He would buy stuffs and he would prefer to cycle all around. And he would say that, you know, it is our responsibility to save our environment for the cause of greenery and green environment. Why should we pollute it? And cycling is something I love to do because it is causing no pollution at all. And at the same time, I am so fit. And you know, I play badminton in my building, and he's a badminton champion in his, even the younger people, youth of his society are also not able to beat him. He's that good at badminton. So daily morning he plays badminton, then he goes for cycling. So his routine is so beautiful and full of enthusiasm. That is why I told in the first video that they look younger to their age, because they keep on doing something or the other. They are always on the go, on the edge to do something new. So this was lichen planus getting cured by Merksol. Then there was a plum boy is there, a hefty fellow, and he had those white patches all over his body, okay, from neck down onwards up to the feet, and on his back, on his abdomen, on his chest, on his thighs, on his legs, hands, everywhere white patches, and very itchy patches. Now as these patches were itchy and with perspiration, the more he perspires, the more he plays, that itching aggravates so much. But then he doesn't apply anything. You know, all this case is after, in this scenario of lockdown, when lockdown just opened and he was constrained in the house and he didn't like it and he wanted to go out. And as soon as the lockdown opened, he was the first person to run out of the house. And once he started going out, he would just want to stay down only with his friends. From morning to night, he doesn't want to come at home at all. So whatever he wants, he will just call up his mama. Oh mama, order this, I want to eat this. Oh mama, order that, I want to eat that. And parents are also very chilled out. They are ordering burger, pizza, sandwich, whatever he wants. They are just ordering, and he is just coming home to eat. He will just eat whatever is coming home, and then he will go down again. He is not bothered to have a bath at home also. I mean, there is so much of itching, so much of perspiration, but he doesn't care. Means I don't know to have, I don't have the time to have bath. Bath is not a priority. Bath is not a necessity. Why should I have bath? So I, after seeing his skin condition, the first thing I told him, for how many days do you not have bath? So he's like, if I'm in a mood, then I have bath. Otherwise, I forget and I just sleep in the night. So mama is like, for 3-4 days also, he will go without having a bath. I was like, what? 3-4 days without a bath? Means, and so much is the physical activity of that boy. And he's eating and he's overweight because of that. So with Merksol, his patches gradually reduced, and he started having bath also on at least once a day in the night time. That too, he's like, subah na aunga to, if I have bath in the morning, then whole night again I have perspiration. So I better to have bath in the night and then sleep. So this is how his problem resolved. Then there was a case of otitis media, chronic otitis media. It was presented by Dr. Shilpa from Pune in one of our seminars, where the he was an old man, and I don't remember the exact story of that old man, but I know the expressions of that old man, that he was so much angry with anyone and everyone around, from his family members, from his social circle. According to him, nobody is perfect. Everyone has faults, and he was only full of complaints about society as a whole, about his family relations, everything and everyone and anyone. So he was a very unhappy fellow, a discontented fellow, a very morose, you can say, a very irritated fellow. With everything he's irritated. I don't like this, I don't like that. He was only going on and on about the complaints, and he was having big ideas to restructure or reframe the societal rules and everything, although he was not doing anything, but he was only cribbing about everything. So that was this case. Then there was one case of ankylosing spondylitis I had attended from one of the doctors. I don't remember the case exactly again, but then that boy had this autoimmune disorder set inside his body at such a young age. He was just 20s, in his 20s, and because of discords in his family and because he could not pursue his ambition due to these discords, that so much of anger had set inside him that he just was rebelling with everyone, complaining about everyone, and he was not appreciative of whatever his family was trying to do to make him happy and healthy, not appreciative of anything. And in that state also, he had big plans for his life, but everything had gone in a mess, and that was a destructive state of Merxol in this case. Then there is one aunt of mine. Why I'm narrating these back-to-back cases, and then I'll tell the later part of Merxol quickly, because you'll be able to correlate with cases, the rubrics and the case. Okay. Now in this aunt, you know, this aunt, I would visit her since my childhood. I'm seeing her, and when her son got married, the elder son got married. She had lot of problems with her daughter-in-law, and she is the one, you know, who was not given space to move out of her house. She would not be allowed to get social with people because of lot of disputes in her family. Her husband was her second husband, and due to those restrictions and a bad situation, she was stuck in the house. But in the house also, she would be aware of what is going on in our community, in our circle, and then whomever she would speak to, her sisters, her children, her relatives, she would keep on complaining about things and about what wrong people are doing, and to the extent that she would get abusive about people. You know, she would give those bad Hindi abusive words also, which normally men use. But being a lady, she was the first one to whom I saw that with that much of boldness, she would just speak out all those words in front of children also. So that was her nature since beginning. And now then that she was diagnosed of cervical spondylitis. Spondylitis means complete destruction of cervical neck bones, vertebral bones. And in that destructive phase, her neck was completely under spasm, and she was not able to even move her neck even 1 degree angle. It was just stuck. And in that pain, I spoke to her, and I spoke to her son, actually, the younger son who is not yet married. And then she's like, I told him what happened, and you know, she's not well, I came to know. So then I told him, give her the phone, let me talk to her. So she refused, I don't want to talk to her, I don't want to take anything, this is all pain and all will subside, let it be, it's okay, I don't want any treatment. And she's the one, for so many years, I came to know that day, that for so many years, every day she has been taking 4 to 5 painkillers. Whenever there would be a pain in her neck and her head would ache with pain and she would have vertigo problem, she would pop a painkiller and she would just carry on her day's work. So 4 to 5 painkillers in a day, and then gradually leading to this state that you know, it will be fine, it's okay, I don't want to disturb her, it is okay, leave it, I will be fine. And then I came to know that she was taking that hot fermentation and all that, warm oil massage and everything. She was trying everything just to get rid. She was like popping up painkillers like anything. So this is the height of frivolousness. Frivolous doesn't mean that not taking medicine is only frivolous, but frivolous is also this, that not having any limitation to take a painkiller also. I mean, you are not serious about it. You know that what are the repercussions of a painkiller, but she doesn't bother about it. It's okay, let me just take and keep doing my work. That was her attitude. And with Merxol, daily repetition I gave her, morning and night, she started moving and her pain subsided a lot. Her vertigo subsided gradually and she's in a very good, stable condition now. So she understood that homeopathy works. She was never in favor of homeopathy. When she came to know I became a homeopathic doctor, she's like, what is homeopathy? What she must be doing? So when she felt the effect, that is when she got convinced about it. Then there was Mohanty sir's case of diabetes, where he had shown that a plump lady and she had diabetes and she was, I have sugar, I have sweets, I can't live without sweets, I want samosas, I can't live without it, that is something I just love. And your sugar levels, your diabetes, that will be taken care of, it's okay, you give medicine for that. So carry desire with frivolous, with government combination comes to be Merxol. Okay, so these are some of the cases. Now the later part of Merxol, I would quickly sum up in this video itself, where you see there is anarchist revolutionary spirit in them. They want to do something new, they don't want to take the dictatorship of anybody, they want to set their own path, they are protesting people, the freedom fighters of our country, many of them must have been Merxol, now also people who are inventing new things. Okay, then they can't take contradiction, they find problem in their relations and in their surroundings, those problems are all around them. Okay, and they will complain about them, lament about them, aversion to those people, company aversion, want to get into country away from people, discontented with surrounding, delusion, everyone is enemies, surrounded by enemies, houses full of people means no attachment, it's just a house, indifference to surrounding people, family, loved ones, suspicious, considering everybody his enemy, that there is nobody who is mine, they are all enemies, they don't understand me, they don't stand by me, and they are always against me, wanting to put me down, wanting to attack me. So this is occult desire to her loved ones during menses aggravate. Recognizing does not recognize relatives, own house. So even the loved ones become his enemy in Merxol. They become very cynical people. Cynical are those people who are always into self-interest and who feel that better to just mind our own business and look into our own life. What is there in other suggestions? What others are doing? They don't do anything for us. They're so full of negativity about others actually. So then consolation, sympathy, aggravate, delusion. Abusive, child insulting parents, malicious, insulting. So, you know, see how picking at nose comes to the level of insult. They start insulting out and out. They speak anything which will hurt the sentiments of others. Anger, so he could have stabbed anyone. So that is the impulse. Anger with weeping from pain, delirium, raging, scolding, moral feeling, want of disposition to become criminal without remorse. So when so much of energy is expended, gradually their energy levels start coming down and they go to a state where they no longer can pull themselves so much and do things out and out, activity, the activeness starts reducing, duty, no sense of business, incapacity, ambition, loss of to make money where so much of ambition and clarity was there. Delusion, everything will fail, dullness after injuries to head, playing aversion, playing inability. These are the people who never succeed when they come in this kind of mindset. Okay, delusion, sick being in mind and body. Delusion seems as if the senses would vanish. Disgust with oneself, has no courage to live with oneself. Delusion made of sweets. Sweets is what again, you know, if there is a sweet kept on the floor, you will immediately see insects coming in, ants will come, flies will come, you know, everything will come and start attacking the sweet. So they feel they are made of sweet because they are surrounded by enemies and everyone is attacking them or trying to destroy them, and that is how the feeling comes. That delusion, living things creep into mouth, living things creep into vagina. So vagina and mouth are what places of our body, na? They are the open mucous membranes of our body, the very open the openings, natural openings of our body, through where the insects can easily creep in, living things can creep, cockroaches, ye wo, those creatures can creep in who are who have the ability to destroy their body functions. So that is the sign of again infections, right? Parasites can creep in and they will suck you out, suck the energy of your body. So that is how they feel that their own people are sucking them out and making their life a hell. Okay, so discouragement about future, death thoughts of without fear. Then there comes a when they commit all these crimes, when they become violent, in that state there is an important rubric, restlessness of conscience, that as if they have committed a crime, as if they have done wrong, and then that conscience is there which always keeps marks all on their toes, that oh I have done this, oh is it correct, is it not correct, and I should have done this, but the impulse is so strong, the anger is so much there, that is why conscience is always restless. Then there is fear of suicide on seeing a knife, kill desire too with hysterical sadness. So those hysterical sadness is what? When you see Shaheed Bhagat Singh, that movie is there, hysterical sadness. That is the hysteria in which they will fire, they will kill people, they will do all sorts of destruction. They know that this is not wrong and it pinches them to the heart to see all these things going around them. Then, you know, after that, sick being and countryside desire for, disgust with oneself, then there is a state of absolute morbidity, the pathological state, the state which you will see out and out directly when you go to mentally retarded places, when you go to, when you see people in a mental asylum. Those are the direct rubrics which can be interpreted in a very subtle manner also. Dirty, urinating and defecating, their food everywhere. Orientation decrease, nibble desire to. Delusion sees mutilated bodies, laconic, so they become less talkative. Delirium murmuring, shrieking when touched, rage at sight of water. Insanity with wantonness, withdrawal from reality, loss of willpower. Delusion, delirium puts stones in the mouth. So stone in the mouth is what? Who does this? Actually, a child, an infant, you will see, they will put little stones in their mouth. So that is what they are wanting to just pacify themselves, to relax themselves. This is what they start doing, that you know, I just have to be okay, I have to cool down, or I can't speak, I can't express in any other way. This is how they can express them. Then there was a special child of Merksall, autistic. In that case, he would hit anybody and everybody. He didn't know how to talk. He is a 9 or 10 year old boy, but he can't communicate. So how does he communicate? He will keep striking everyone here and there. So if you see the keynotes of Merksall, where it is, in the first video also I said that where they are very communicative people, they talk very fluently. And such people, when they are not able to speak up, or when they are not able to express properly, this is how they express. The communication comes out by touching, by hitting, by striking, by irritating people, that you know, give attention to me, or I am also here, or I also want to eat, or I also want to play. This is how they express and they laugh about it. So this is all about Merksall. I hope you find it useful and use it in your practice with great success. And do subscribe to my channel, share about it with your friends, and all the very best. And do attend our HHF webinars coming and ongoing, and they will keep going on. Take care. Bye.